Hi everyone, this is Brendan here and welcome to my next episode, Day 12 of my Let's Clash series. So I started the day off by attacking this Tower 8, focusing on the top, trying to get the gold from the gold mines itself. I didn't really want to bother about the elixir because my elixir is like at 400,000 and I didn't need elixir for my next upgrades that I'm gonna do. So only focusing on the gold, stealing the 200,000 gold from the gold mines as they were really full, and then eventually just ending the battle, conserving my troops at the same time, also just losing the battle. So back to my base, one of my builder was free, done with the gold storage upgrade, eventually using my free builder to try to get some gems from the tree, and then the tree, it got me 4 gems, eventually going ahead to do more upgrades, upgrading the walls, spending the gold on the walls, trying to not have any gold available for other people to loot, that's one. And also trying to upgrade my walls to pink crystal wall, which is the max possible for my current Town Hall level, Town Hall 6. And then once I hit to Town Hall 7, which is going to be in a few days time, I'll be upgrading to the dark purple wall, which will be what I'm actually looking for. So now getting one of the upgrade done, my wizard tower. So I decided to get the wizard tower because it took 12 hours to upgrade, and then after 12 hours I'll be able to have another free builder and then eventually use my gold, which I'm gonna farm to actually pump into the walls again. And then now, as you can see, the goblin just got to level 3, researched to level 3, and then eventually I got to wall breaker, getting them to level 3 also. So I'm trying to focus on wall breaker because I'll be eventually using a goby white as in golem, wizard, witch, and also P.E.K.K.A. So I need wall breakers to be rather high in level, maybe around level 5 to use them properly. So another raid with just a gold mines available for me to steal. So focusing on the top, the gold mines, 300,000 gold available, managed to steal 230,000 gold from it, which was really awesome. And then eventually finding another Tower 8, which had a lot of gold exposed also. However, this base was a little tricky, as later you will see what actually went wrong. So deploying my troops as normally, just trying to split them up because this time I needed some elixir as I wanted to stock up some elixir for my next few upgrades. So eventually, as now we focus at the bottom, a lot of the troops got taken out. I didn't really notice until when I actually wanted to drop my clan castle at the bottom so that it could actually clear out the cannons. However, a lot of my archers already been taken out, and my barbarians, they went down really quickly. I'm not too sure why. But then eventually, the balloons managed to take out some of the cannons, leaving also the wizards being taken out. So it's now up to my balloons to try to take out the mortar. If the mortar doesn't go down, it will definitely take out all my archers, which will eventually screw up the raid itself. So with 65,000 gold left in the gold mines, I was thinking whether is it possible for my archers to actually break through the wall, to actually go into the gold mine section to take out the gold mines, because I only had like a few more archers left, just like a handful of archers to try to bust through the wall. Eventually they managed to, and then they start to steal some of the gold from the gold mines, destroying the first gold mine, eventually going ahead to the second one and then getting it out too. And then after that, now proceeding on into the last one, stealing all the gold, and thankfully now just ending the battle with a 1 star 51%, stealing all the loot. So going ahead with the next attack, I'd like to show you guys against this Town Hall 6. So deploying my troops like ants at the bottom, and then just following up with a V-shaped manner, and then just focusing them at the very bottom so that they could take out the gold mines and also the elixir collectors, as that's the ones that I'm actually focusing on. However, eventually I realized that why don't I try to go for a 3 star. So I dropped my balloons on the top to try to take out those ground attacking defenses first, such as the cannons. And then eventually as you can see on the top there, my wizards got taken out because the cannons just take them out really quickly. However, I decided to change my clan castle a bit as compared to what I used previously, using 2 balloons, 2 wizards, and a minion. I find this strategy at this clan castle combination much better than using like all balloons or whatsoever. I rather have like 2 balloons and the rest minions. However, I decided to use 2 wizards because once I have like a barbarians in front and then I drop the wizards basically, they are very strong. Later you guys will see some raids using it, especially this particular one as you can see. So with 400,000 gold available, definitely they are all inside the gold mines. As you can see, the gold storage, they are very empty. So focusing on the gold mines, eventually as you can see on the wizard on the right there, got just take out the gold mines. And then eventually a lot of my troops got taken out by the mortar. Mortar doing a lot of damage, especially for Tower 8, they have like 4 mortars right now. Last time they only had 3, so it was pretty difficult. So I only managed to steal like 326,000. Apparently there are a few more gold inside the gold storage itself. So going ahead to attack this Town Hall 8 again, this Town Hall 8 is kind of tricky to attack because I do not want to spread my troops around the whole entire base, otherwise I won't have enough troops to carry on the whole entire attack. And also, I'm just focusing on the gold mine and focusing on those exposed structures. So this is another strategy that I use. Instead of just spreading my troops out, spamming them all out instantly, I can also just drop them to try to snipe the remaining structures on the outside, those exposed ones that ain't protected at all. And then eventually, once they have taken out all those structures on the outside, they will actually proceed on inside the base, towards the base, and then eventually get taken out by the defenses. But that's not to worry. Maybe I will use like only one or two archers to try to take out like one or two buildings. Eventually, they get taken out. So in order to just speed things up, I didn't want to put and wait for one archer to take out like one building. So eventually, I dropped like a few more troops to try to take out one particular building. However, it's only attacking halfway, then I realized that the percentage was very low and I was going to lose the attack if I didn't use my clan castle. And then I realized that also that this base is quite strong against barbarians and archers, because the structures, they are well protected by the archer towers, which took out a lot of my troops really quickly. So I tried my luck dropping my clan castle on the left side, and then my balloons came out. Wizards in the end went down by the attack of the cannons. So I'm thinking whether I should change my clan castle or just stick to this clan castle, because if I were to use them in this particular manner whereby I do not have any barbarians to tank in front, they will actually go down really quickly. So back to my base, the wizard tower has just completed after 12 hours of upgrading. And having 2 million gold available for me to upgrade my walls, I decided to upgrade the walls definitely. So upgrading them to pink crystal walls again, so the same usual, just pumping my gold into the wall. So of course, before this, I did a lot of raids trying to stock up my gold to 2 million. So in that 12 hours, definitely I was able to get 2 million gold. In fact, in 12 hours, less than 12 hours, I already got the 2 million. So I was just waiting for time to pass for my wizard tower to be ready. And then eventually I could use the gold into my walls. So I'm not exactly trying to rush the level of my walls. If I'm planning to rush the level of my walls, I might have actually used the builder to upgrade other stuff that maybe would only use up 6 hours instead of 12 hours. So that I could actually use the go up really quicker, but I didn't want to do that because I still have many days, in fact like 4 days till my town hall reaches town hall 7. So I still have plenty of days and plenty of time to actually upgrade the walls, so it didn't really bother me that much. In fact, in just like another one more or just two more free builder available for me, I should be able to get the walls done and ready and up for this particular town hall level. So in the end, just upgrading the elixir storage, counting my gold exactly to 250,000 gold. So now let's take a look at this particular raid. As you can see, it's a Town Hall 7. Clan Castle has just came out with a level 5 wizards, and then eventually I tried to lightning out the wizards, which actually failed because a level 1 lightning spells are just pretty weak. So in the end, I dropped my own clan castle, which contains 5 wizards. So I tried out the different clan castle combination. So I find that having 5 wizards is the way better strategy to use them than the balloons. So I might be using 5 wizards instead of 2 balloons. So I might see how. So as you can see, the town hall has gone down. Then eventually the wizards, they are doing a lot of damage, taking out in fact up to the half damage of the gold storage itself. So stole a lot of gold from this particular raid, 227,000. And then eventually finding this 400,000 gold available on this particular base itself. But the gold mines, they were all spread out. Level 12 gold mines, they stock up a lot of gold. So I decided to just focus on the gold storages. Already got like half of the amount from just like 3 or 4 of the gold mines. Eventually my troops just continued to try to do more damage. And also the Barbarian King is being a kind of a nuisance to my archers. Eventually the Barbarian King, he did do a lot of damage to my archers. However, my archers, they were strong enough. Level 3 archers did take out that Barbarian King. If it's like a level 40 Barbarian King, I'm pretty sure my troops won't be able to take it out. Eventually just taking out that last gold mine and getting us 363,000 gold. So yeah, that's it for this particular episode. I hope to update you guys tomorrow with more upgrades, more updates, and more progress in my base. So with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my video, and clash on.